Hello everyone, welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Repentance. Alright, let's just bring my microphone a little bit closer, just a tiny little bit. There we go. Alright, I'm ready. Let's get to it. So, we are currently at 21 wins in a row, with Eden going to the chest. And yeah, we're going to go for run number 22 today. Here we go. Eden, hard, 21, a yoink. Alright. Let's see what we got then. Magic skin. Okay, probably not going to be using that. I forget what this does. It's that heart thing. It multiplies. I know that much. That's that temporary invincibility thing. So that could be pretty good. We will wait to take that though. To see if we get a bomb which we can use to then, you know, get it for free sort of thing. So yeah, the streak continues. We are getting closer to, I don't know what the record is, what our record is for Eden, but I would say we're getting closer to that record. From experience, my streaks usually end in the 20s, so it's a spooky time. It is spooky time when it comes to the streaks, but hopefully we can make it last a little bit longer this time, who knows. I hope so. You never know though. Well, what's down here? A black market. Interesting. What do we got? This would be really good actually. This would be really good. Especially for our boss. We'll wait though. We'll wait. Because, yeah, I think it's best to wait just to see if we get any more health. Because it would be a little bit risky losing our health at this point. Unfortunate fire placement. Okay. Lots of choice here on this floor. No bombs to use it. To get that with. I think we're going to risk it. I think we are going to go and take the white question mark right now. It's a bit of a risk versus reward. But I think that's worth it. So what that does is that the white one, there's two different question mark items. The white one means you get multiple choice of items from boss rooms, and the golden one is item rooms. But we now will have a choice of two items from our boss room. So yeah, let's see. I mean, I don't know what I was worried about. No, it could have been a lot worse. Also, this layout is unlike anything I've ever seen before. I've never seen this layout. Very cramped, very small. Weird. Well, I'm definitely going to be taking this. The tears up. I don't really think there's much else I can do here. There is that item that I would like, but I don't think I can take it, you know? We don't have the health to spare. And these spikes take one full heart, so I think, honestly, it's probably best we just leave this. I do like it, but that spike, yeah, it's not worth it. We will blow this up, though. Wow, okay, well, that's pretty good. Ghost baby. Hell yeah. I'll take that. A good first floor item. That honestly makes up for the fact that we're not getting tooth and nail. I'm not even mad. Alright. Let's move on to the next floor. Bit of a spooky start. Oh yeah, the seed. H2WA4ZBQ. That is today's seed. I always forget to do the seed. Just never something I ever need to use myself, you know? Okay, that was weird. Oh, I see. That's what that does. It will give you a heart every floor. Interesting. An empty heart. Interesting. Yeah, it's just one of those items that I always just sort of skip. It's never really something I mess with. But that's fine. It's one of those items where I see it and I'm like, I don't really know what this does, but I'm just going to skip it. Because it isn't, like, actively helpful to the run. I will eventually get better at that sort of thing, I hope. Yeah, we can get in here. I will open that up. Hey, we got a bomb. Very nice. I will take you straight away. Beautiful. Sticky bombs, so now we get more bombs as well. Awesome. We can use Ghost Baby to my advantage. I can just stand here and just hit these enemies with this guy to avoid potential getting hitness. There we go. We could go in the shop, but I think we're going to skip it for now. Only 5 coins. Not much I can do with that. There we go. Nice, nice, nice. And we found the boss, of course. So it's pretty cool. Because we got that question mark early, we're now going to get a lot more uses out of it than if you were to pick it up late. It's one of those items, right? The earlier you get the white question mark, the better it is for the run. If you get it late, it's like it really doesn't matter at all. So it's a time-dependent item, I would say. Look at that, we get another tears up, tears and shot speed. Beautiful. What's in here? This guy messes me up every single time I take him, but I'm gonna take him anyway. I'm gonna do it. And he messes me up because every time I actually want to use a red heart, he'll just take it and use it for himself. My opinion has changed on Dark Bum. Originally, I thought he was like one of the better items in the game. He's like, you know, one of the best. But in recent times, I'm just like, yeah, this guy's not the best. He's okay, but does kind of ruin a lot of strategy when it comes to red hearts. Okay, the red key. That's very spicy indeed. So the red key is great. It will allow you to access red rooms, as you can see. And yeah, red rooms can have all sorts of cool goodies in it. The main place to use red key is, past a special room. And what I mean by past is like, so you'll like go into the item room and then you can use it in the item room to go a room past it. I don't know how else I can describe it, but yeah, that's the best place to use it because you can potentially find ultra secret rooms. Ultra secret rooms always have an item in it and they are always the color red. So we are going to be looking for a lot of ultra secret rooms because any item that has red in it is in there. So Sacred Heart is red. That could be in there. You never know. You never know. Any red item. So it's definitely worth it. So yeah, like up here, for example, there could be an ultra secret room connected diagonally to that. Or the shop. I reckon it's probably the shop. Based on the location, but that's fine. There is a battery. We can test it. Let's give it a go. Yeah, look at that. We found the ultra secret. Very nice. Was it worth it? It was not. But hey, at least we know, right? At least we know that it was there. At least they found it. So there you go. There's just proof of how to use the red key efficiently. And if you've found it, like the ultra secret, you can just use it wherever. It really doesn't matter. Or you can try and use it for shortcuts, I guess. That's the only other use for it. So, like, if there's a weird looping, weird, like, winding floor, you can kind of use it to create little shortcuts back for yourself. Great item, though. One of the better items, better use items. That's a bit unfortunate. We're gonna waste a usage on this room. Or not. Because big rooms like this give you two charges. And regular rooms like this only give you one. So, I was worried I was gonna waste a use. But we didn't. I'll use it here. Just because we've got it ready and available. They can be anything as well. I remember a while ago we had two angel rooms next to each other, directly next to each other in a run. And in total we had three angel rooms on that floor. So red rooms can really open up anything. They can give you shops on later floors. It's really, really good. Would recommend to a friend in 4K. Ow. Getting a bit unlucky with these dudes. And their location. Ooh, that's a bit tight. Yeah, we're fine. Cool. Sure. We'll do this. I'll blow all these up before. It could be a bit dangerous. And yeah, I'll check here as well. It works out better for us that way. Then we get more charges for it. I don't want to waste charges if I can help it. So yeah, for each wave of this room, we get one charge as well, so it's definitely worth doing this. Can open up another red room after here. Go. Wheel of 4chan. Well, look, we got an arcade here. Cool. Blow these up. Gimme, gimme, gimme. A man after midnight. No. There you go. Another way that that guy ruins things. think we'll use a bomb here on these mushrooms as well. Right there. What are you, metronome? Nah. That's always a word I've kind of struggled with. Is it metronome or metromome? Metromome. Metronome. Always been a weird one. Yeah, I guess we'll take piggy bank. It's not a massive thing for us to take, but sure. Jump cables. I mean, that'll help us recharge our key, so sure. Gives us more uses. I believe Bloody Recharge is basically like the vampire item, but it's for charges instead, I think. Let's try this. It's either going to be diagonal to the shop or diagonal to the item room. We'll try the item room. Or not, we'll try the shop. It's probably the shop. So like down here and to the right? No? Okay, fair enough. Could be anywhere really. Doesn't have to be here. But I just find that it usually is there more often than not. Alright, boss time. And it's Pestilence. Great. It's fine. Usually I'm not a fan of getting the ball of meat. But in this case, we do have the question marks, so we're okay. It would be kind of neat, and I don't know if we are going to reach that. Because we don't have like a reroll device. I think it's possible if you get it like on the first floor like we did. And in this case, I'll just take this. Yeah, if you get like a re-rolling device, like a, you know, D6 or something. Oh, this might mean there's a secret room here. Because there's no key. Okay, it's just the end of the floor then. Yeah, if you get it alongside like a D6 or whatever, you can actually exhaust the pool of boss room items. If you re-roll it enough. And you can get all sorts of cool stuff from there. So, yeah. Worth it if you've got, like, a D6 or something. Anyway, let's move on. My guess for the secret room is probably past the curse room. But we don't have the health to really support that at the moment. So we're just going to move on. And I hope we do get the health to support our run. That would kind of suck if we didn't. Why do I feel like the secret room's here? Okay, it's not. It'd be a good place for one, though. It's a believable location. It's a pretty horrible one. There we go. Yeah, let's just go here. Wow! Now, that is a rare room. You don't see that every day. Well, I'm going to break this first. Okay. Because sometimes there can be that, that penny in there. Wow, I'm practically at 100 coins now. Awesome. Yeah, really rare room. I have seen that maybe 2 or 3 times in the past. But it's very uncommon. Okay, now we're just actually wasting money if we pick it up, so we probably should just not pick it up at all. I want some more range. Our range is tiny at the moment. 5 range. It's not good enough. Just like my internet situation, it's not good enough. And yeah, best way to take out this room is just to stay on one side and take them out one by one as they come to you, sort of thing. Not too bad. Oh, snap! Okay, there you go. Stem cells, that's pretty good. Ow. That's fine. Well, I think we're definitely going to play this. I do not want to take this, but I want to at least play the machine to see what's in here. Glass cannon is very dangerous. It's not an item I want to take. Come on. I don't even really want this item, but at least if we take it, we can at least see what's underneath. Okay. Yeah, that wasn't worth it. But if we pick that up and put it down, we just, you know, we at least get 5 free bombs from that. So it's always worth it. And on top of that, we get golden bombs as well. So that's really good for the floor as well. Definitely going to be using that. Because we are on the caves. Caves 2. So there's going to be mushrooms all over the place which we can use. To potentially get magic mush or mini mush. Yeah, I'll take that. Take you, and I'll take you. Didn't want to break that open, but fair enough. Very cool, though. We're doing alright for health. This has been the health floor. So yeah, a little tip when it comes to the key as well, you can actually find secret rooms easier because there won't be a little red key mark on the door. So like on this door there was no red key mark, that means there's a high chance of it being a secret room or just inaccessible, but you know what I mean. Another luck up. Unfortunately, we don't have anything that actually uses luck at the moment, but maybe we'll get them. Who knows? More luck is always a good thing. You here. Didn't need to, but why not? Another one of you. Okay. Interesting. I've been in the shop this floor, yeah. Can play you. I don't like that item, but it's more what's underneath is what I'm interested in. Yes, I do want this item. Wow. That's a really low chance of getting all three of them like that. Ooh, the trinket as well, the cancer trinket. That's a tears up. This is a tears up. We now have 6 tier 8. I like indeed. Get a black heart as well. Sure, we'll use you. So my general sort of rule for surviving in this room, pick like a column or whatever, like a row or column going up or down, like this row, for example, is perfect right here. There's no spikes on that at all. And just walk up and down. And if you actually need to, then go left and right to avoid getting hit. But try and just stay up or down, because otherwise you're just going to walk into the spikes and get hurt a lot. And it's not worth the damage. Ooh, tech point 5, hell yeah. Very nice. Very cool. Where am I going? Cuba meat blocked that shot there. That was quite nice. Okie dokie. I think we move on to the next floor now. Pretty good. We'll check what's in here as well, because why not? Overall, pretty successful floor. Less mushrooms than I thought there would be. Ow. Ow. On a bad cycle. It's fine. Yeah, you can, like, I was trying to, like, use the cube of meat to hurt him there, but it didn't really work. Yes, I would like you. Damage and range. Range is something I'm lacking in, so that's great. And, yeah, let's move on. Damage is always good as well. Those are two things I needed, and we got it. Speed is the next thing I would like. I feel very slow. I'm struggling. Wasted some charges here, but that's fine. These can be kind of dangerous, those spiky things, if you have low speed as well. Well, you better believe I'm going straight in here. And that is a mega no. I'm not taking that. Just isn't very good. Okay, well, I can't use anything here. Or here. Well, here, I can't use it. Can't use my red key. Can use it here, though. Yoink. Well, that's something I should definitely have thought about before going in here. Making sure it wasn't a curse room. The world. Okay. That's pretty cool. Ooh. Alright, loads of stuff happening right now. A lot of stuff. Alright. Let's try this room. Yeah, I've learnt my lesson now. Don't go directly in there. Just open the door and then wait. Because that could be really bad. We're going to use the world. What's down here? Another black market? That's two in a row. Not in a row, but... Two in the same run. I don't want any of that, so I'm going to roll it. Red stew's kind of cool, but we don't have anything like rock bottom, so no. Golden membership card, sure. new. A new. And a no. Those are just none of those things I want, really. Pretty cool. Pretty cool indeed. So because we've got a golden membership card, we should be able to go in here. Get another reroll machine? Sure. I want this. That's another tiers up. Don't even need it, really. But sure. Not bad. What is this? It's only Dank Depths 1, we don't need to use that yet. But yeah, pretty cool. Pretty cool stuff. Got a lot from that. This room likes to keep teleporting. It's a weird curse we got right now. It makes the rooms switch around all over the place. So we're just gonna go through here. Yeah, one of the items we could have taken as well was that 9-volt battery item, which would have meant that we get to go in rooms more often. But I don't really think we need it. Is it worth one health for that? I don't think so. Hey, there's the top secret, or the ultra secret. Hey, nice, we got meat. So that was free. That item we took that time, that one time, was free. Gold membership. That was completely free. Wow, squished monstro. Is this the key one? It looks like the key variant. I think we get a key from this. Not sure. Another luck up. Getting a lot of luck. Wow, yeah, we're getting so many charges on this key now, it's ridiculous. Let's go exploring deeper, shall we? Into the red verse, the red universe. There is actually an edge as well to the map. You can't just keep going forever. It's a massive one, and there's actually a challenge, like an in-game challenge that revolves around that. Like you start as Tainted Jacob, and you get a massive charged key, and you basically find the floor. You just explore the whole floor. And when that runs out, you spawn like one of your little Tainted Jacob ghosts or whatever. I do not like the Tainted Jacob ghost whatsoever. It is something I actively avoid getting. Tainted Jacob is one of those characters where I have not played him since I finished all of the unlocks. And I don't think I ever will. It's not a character that I enjoy. Like, yeah, you can use his, like, abilities for good. But it's just not for me, really. Not for me. This is actually a pretty important item for us over this. This is good, and your first thought would be this, but we have maximum fire rate. However, this will make our fire rate even faster because it breaks the tier cap. There's a tier cap of 5, but we got 6 because we've got this trinket, because that raises your tier rate by 1. And that item we just picked up will increase it. Well, it'll break the tier cap, so you can go above the maximum tier rate. I think it's just, yeah, here it's an obvious pick just to go with this, More of the Void. Easy pick. Causes a little black circle like that to appear. And sure, we'll go in here just to finish this floor. Alright, onward we go. Going pretty well. Pretty well indeed. And now we are on depth 2, the final floor with a shop and an item room. So if we get a donation machine, we should probably use it as much as we can. Unless we get like a shop in a red room, maybe. I don't know. Can't use my key anywhere. Honestly, I don't think I want that item. I prefer to not have tears that go through enemies. Shot speed's good. But nah. What do you have? Anything juicy? Oh, health up. Hell yeah. I would say that's juicy. Juicy Lucy. Don't like them, they're quick. Okay, what we got in here? I'll definitely be taking that. Soul of Isaac. Take that. These two can stay here. This is just fire rate of the familiars, and this one is an occasional poison shot, which might not be the worst because we do have quite high luck, but I don't think we really need it. I would much prefer the higher fire rate than a chance to poison. Yeah, let's take that. We could use the Soul of Isaac. I think I'll wait, though, until there's something that I think is good, but I could potentially have better. Because it gives you the option between the two, the original or the new item when you reroll with it. Didn't mean to do that. Okay, we got an arcade. Nah, I'm not interested in that. It's not for me. You up. Actually, yeah, the only thing we can get from skulls now is dry baby. Ooh, Okay, interesting. That is unlimited bombs, this item. I'll be taking you. Rotten tomato. That's good. And I think we'll just reroll this. It's good, but no. Oh! Yes! Compound fracture. That's bone tears. Look at that. We're bad to the bone. So yeah, bone tears, whenever you hit your enemy with a tear, it'll kind of split off into multiple smaller tiers. So it's just a major damage up that. Look at the chaos. Little bones flying everywhere. Tis good. I'm glad we found that. Those are probably two of the best items we've found this run so far. Okie dokie. I think we move on to the next floor now. After taking out the boss and after being in this secret room that's obviously right here, of course. Why wouldn't it be right there? Oh yeah, we should also go back in the shop as well. Wow, that's crazy that we got this item. Ooh. We're in a secret room. Get a reroll with Soul of Isaac. Let's do it.
Soul of Isaac.
Whatever. Whatever. It could have been good. It could have been amazing. You never know. We could have had death certificate. We could have had glitched crown. You never know. I always like to go for a little cheeky reroll. You know me. And before we move on, I am going to be donating all this money here. There, supplies for future runs. I remember when we were at 420 for a really long time. Now we're at 500. Beautiful. Nice. Polaroid, and yeah, I'll take a little damage up. Sure, why not? And you know what? I'll take Demon Baby as well. Because then all we need is one more little familiar to fire for us, and we get conjoined, which is a triple shot. Therefore, tripling our entire damage. So it's worth it. Well worth it. Game. That was weird. The game just stopped working. It was like, nope, I'm done for a bit. Let me catch my breath. That was really odd. Everything just stopped. It was a glitch in the Matrix. We're going to be using that battery in a minute. By a minute, I mean right now. If I can pick up all of these collectibles and my voice doesn't break. Ooh, straight away, look at that. Very nice. Plum flute? Nah, not even worth it. Not worth. I'm fairly certain as well, it really doesn't matter which room you use red key on. I don't think it makes a difference. Like, you know. Oh, wouldn't it be cool if the further you went out from the main floor, the better items you got? But no, it's not like that at all. Bloody crown. Ooh. Well, too bad we don't have more trinket slots. That would have been cool to mess with. Oh, wow, okay, we found an error room. That's not what I wanted. Gotta be careful not to do that on the next floor, now that I think about it. That's like a rude awakening. So if I were to use it on the next floor, that would actually lock us out of the ending we want to go to. Because now we can't leave this floor. Oh, we can. We got the Hermit card. Awesome. Whew. Okay, that's like a get-out-of-jail-free card right there. But yeah, I've learnt my lesson. We're not going to use the key on the next floor. Almost soft-locked ourselves out of the ending. Because if you do that on the next floor, there's not going to be a way up. There's just going to be a way down. And, you know, the way down is the wrong floor. So, yeah. That means the streak wouldn't be, like, pure. The streak would still be alive, but it wouldn't be a directly to the chest streak. Like it is at the moment. I want to say we almost got close to killing our streak there. For that reason. It's an awkward place. Yeah, let's... use that here. So yeah, no key on the next floor. I will keep that in mind. Where's the boss? Come on, take this heart. So, like, you see, we could have played the sack room if we didn't take him. But he's just kind of messed up our sack room chances. Like, we could have used the bone heart for that. For our sack room. Algiz isn't bad. I feel like there's a top secret room around here, but maybe not. Ooh. See what I mean? This is what I mean about, like, weird rooms you can get. Get all sorts. We got library. We'll take that. Put it back down. And take the dice shard instead. There it is. I could smell it. I can smell secret rooms. I like how the game was using the curse to try and teleport me places I didn't want to go, yet it was actually teleporting me to the room I wanted to be in. It's going to be up, isn't it? Yep. Oh my god. Ugh, look how far it is away. This is also going to be our last boss room item as well. So after this floor, the white question mark item that we took at the start is... pretty pointless. That battery just disappeared. Oh well. Game's messing with me now. Strange, you don't usually see this boss. Bit uncommon. I guess we go for more luck. We're at 7 luck now. A rare boss room as well, you don't usually see this one. Yeah, let's just go on to the next floor. We're just going to forget about our key for this next floor. And yeah, I could have used my dice shard for that as well. But I didn't. We're going to wait and use that on the chest now, I think. Ooh. Very nice. Well, we can donate more coins, I guess. Can we get the 550? We cannot. So tempting. Actually, we can use it. I'm just not going to go in the rooms unless it's like a special room. Because it could be like an angel room, right? Because the icon shows beforehand. So we'll still unlock them, but I won't go in them. I think it's the best way to do it. See, look, that's a curse room. So that can't possibly... It can't possibly be an error room. Yeah, we'll still use it. We just won't go in them. Unless it's something out of the ordinary. What a weird room that is. Can't say I've seen that one before. In 1,800 hours. Not a great room, but not the worst. I think the modeling clay will count towards triple shot. Don't think so. Interesting thought though. Fun item as we found out last time though. Yeah, what's in here? Ooh. Yeah, I definitely want that. That's great, the pact. Got Leviathan now as well. Little damage up, very cool. Alright. And we go up. Okay. I think we're in a pretty good position. So yeah, working out what the that item is that we started with that I said I didn't really know what it does. It seems that if you get really low on red health, it'll give you a new heart container. when you enter a new room. That seems to be what it does. There's probably like another weird quirk or gimmick with the item. And that's just a simple observation with it. After not having ever really used it. At this point, it doesn't really matter if you get an error room. Really doesn't matter. No big deal. Really unfortunate placement of this here. I'm just going to move it out of the way. Hey, another one. Hell yeah. Oh, flip. Okay. That was a risky one. That was so risky. I had to check though. I had to know. One of these days, me doing that is going to screw me over. And I'm going to be in big trouble. It's going to kill the run. And then I'll learn my lesson. May even be a good thing that it happens. Because then it'll teach me to never pick up blind items. Boss is going to be around here somewhere. Somewhere. I don't know where. But I don't know what was hitting me there. Just random damage. I hate this room because of all the rocks. If you can't shoot through rocks, you can't really do much here. Bit of a pain. Hey, two soul hearts for the two we just lost. That works. Should get quite a few items as well, because the luck stat is actually tied to chests, I believe. The higher luck stat you get, the more chests. So we should be pretty good for the next floor. And there we go. A yoink into the chest. All right, here we go. What are we getting from here? No. No. Yes. Can do better than that. Ooh, mama. Okay. Well, that's pretty cool. We'll take you and we'll take you. We can also now do Mega Stanley, if I so want. Got some cool items here. So Rainbow Fruitcake is the one giving us some weird effects. Making all our tears do weird and odd stuff. Little bit dangerous, Rainbow Fruitcake, because it can make your tears explode. We have full health though. But if I was at low health, I would say no. I'd just be like, nah, not taking that. Not worth it. I think we will do Mega Stanley as well, by the way. Why not? Whoa. This is getting a bit crazy. We'll be taking that. Soul of Eden. So Soul of Eden will reroll items in a room, but it will not take into consideration the room that it's in. So like, that's a devil room item we just got there. It doesn't matter what the item is, it's just what the room it is, it'll just reroll to a random item pool. That's book two. And I'll use this for a familiar. Wow, another four? That's crazy. Do I take this? Sure. I don't know if that's helped us or it's made things worse. I don't know. We're going for the chaos now. The more tears, the better. And I think I've remembered the name of it this time. Lacrifagy. I think it is. I think. I don't know for sure. I like how all our tears are red. I don't like that item, but I took it anyway. Whenever you get hit, it'll, I believe, put out a bunch of, it'll just kind of make you explode into tears, is what I'm trying to say. Not a fan. Take you. I'll take you. We're at that point where the more items, the better, really. The more fun to be had. You? Sure, I'll take, you know, spiders as well. Sure, I'll take my reflection. Big damage up. And our tears will kind of circle back to us. Oh my god! That was great. What do we got here? Wheel of Fortune, Strength, Hermit, Reverse Stars. Can take that. So Reverse Stars, it will get rid of the first item you picked up. You physically picked up. Just removes it and gives you some new ones. definitely not taking that. What's in here? Sure, look at that. You get conjoined now as well because of Sister Maggie. You shoot three tiers now. Look at them all. This is beautiful. So many all over the place. Whoa. It's getting a bit dangerous now. Oh, we got a shop. Oh my goodness. Whew. Okay, well, we get triple shot. So how many tiers is that? Is that six? Oh, I should not be shooting in there. That could blow stuff up. Okay, and what's in here? The Bible? Is that... I think that's the third one. That's worth it. Bookworm, yeah. Ooh, goat head. No point to that now. Yeah, I'll take Jesus juice. It's a little damage up. Sure. Pretty cool. I didn't expect to be coming across a shop at this point. And I'll take the wobbly finger. No, I won't, because it sucks. Yeah, our tiers are getting to a point where they're a little bit dangerous now. To ourselves. Due to random explosions and such. Wow. Alright, let's take out the boss. Pretty cool that build this has turned out to be. So we'll take out the regular boss and then we'll go and do Mega Stanley. Come on, give me some crazy. Give me some pizzazz. Look at that. Awesome. Oh, and we found the Ultra Secret at the end? What do you got? Candle? Nah, I'm not about that. Alright, now let's go and take out Mega Stanley then. Pretty cool build. Pretty cool build to have. Yeah, we'll take Strength instead. And we'll use Strength once we get hit once. That's the best way to do it. Because that gives us extra health. Alright, here we go. Mega Stanley. Pretty fun build, not gonna lie. Yeah, you know, we're pretty strong, I would say. Angel 1, Angel 2. And that is phase 1 done. Dude, the brimstone shots look amazing. Are my tears despawning? I can't tell. It's hard to tell. Not sure. It's a bit dangerous. You see what I mean? Like, you can get to a point where it's too dangerous to go on. I'm not doing that. I'm not going in there. It's too dangerous. Like, we could do it, but I fear that my tears are starting to despawn now, I think. So I'm not going to risk it. But yeah, that's been a really fun run. I had a really good time with that. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you all next time. A yoink. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And join me next time for the 23rd run, I think it is. It's going pretty good. So yeah, I'll see you all next time, and goodbye.